Today on the channel from Boss Fight Studios and the Epic Hacks line, we've got the Barbarian and Gladiator Skeletons.
The spirit of the warrior will run forever!
Kyle here, and welcome back to the channel for another Boss Fight unboxing and review. And today, from the Epic Hacks, we've got the Gladiator and we've got the Barbarian Skeleton. But for all your skeleton needs and a whole lot more, make sure you're hitting up Tainment Earth. Use discount code Kyle. Save yourself 10% on all in-stock items. And of course, anything over $59 does ship free. And we're going to do this review like we do all the other reviews on the channel. We're going to take a look at the packaging. We're going to talk about it. We're going to unbox it. We're going to talk about it. We're going to see where it goes from there. And these two are part of the Epic Hacks skeleton line. And we'll have one more video after this one with two more skeleton figures as well. And I'm all about a skeleton. A lot of us are all about a skeleton. And the last time we unboxed some Boss Fight stuff on the channel was Popeye figure unboxing. So come quite the difference between Popeye figures and these cool, groovy-looking skeletons here. But skeletons always interesting, always great to mingle in with, co-mingle in, I should say, with other toy lines. And I can see a lot of people buying these, army building them. There's a lot of skeleton figure collectors, but there's people that want to buy these maybe for their He-Man figures or their Marvel Legends or maybe their G.I. Joe Classified series. There's a lot of different ways you could go with something like this. So really do like the looks of this. Love that they're in the 6-inch scale universe. So that does make the ease of adding to different collections. Just a really good idea, I think, from Boss Fight Studios. And it's one of those things that's not tied to a property. This isn't He-Man. This isn't G.I. Joe. This isn't Transformers, whatever you want to list off. And it gives them a lot of creative freedom, knowing that people can use these with other things. So I like the idea of these. It'll be interesting to see where this line goes in the future. We do know we have a wrestling figure coming to this line. You know I got that thing on pre-order. Can't wait to get that. But without further ado, let's dive into these. Let's see what all the fuss is about. And I guess we're going to start with the Gladiator one first. Gladiator's up first, I guess. Very interesting packaging. Of course, you got the bubble on the card, a very thin card right here. So if you're looking for a minty mint, it might be a little difficult. It reminds me a little bit of the G.I. Joe Retro Hasbro Pulse Walmart line carding system. But it does look good still. It does display very well. Just going to have to work to get a mint on card one there. Of course, you got the Gladiator, the Destroyer of Empires. I guess that makes sense. A lot of accessories here with this skeleton. Looking good at the card art right there as well. Of course, it is part of the Epic Hacks line. Highly Articulated Character Kit System is what HACKS stands for those keeping track at home. On the back, got the big old blurb. That is a huge monster blurb. I will put it up here. I'm not going to read through this thing. You can pause it. You can read it. But that is War and Peace, which I do love a good blurb. You guys know that. Warnings down below, a little UPC action. Stuff like that going on Boss Fight Studios. Of course, collect them all. We're going to unbox all these on the channel. The Pirate, the Barbarian, the Gladiator, and the Grim Spectre. Very, very cool. The Destroyer of Empires. But without further ado, let's get them out of the package. Adult collectible, age 12 and up. Uh-oh, rookie unboxing going down right here. Oh, come on. What are we doing, Kyle? Act like you've been here before. Act like you've been here before, Kyle. Let's get it out of the package correctly. There we go. Good enough. Good enough. There it is. Off to the races. See you later. Goodbye. So we get two plastic prisons here. I did not realize there was a stand with these. You guys know that. They're playing all the hits right there. I love a good stand. So we do get a little action there. I'm here for that all day long. Get the shield out. Get this out. Plastic. See you later. Goodbye. And a little plastic prison on the old Gladiator. Look at that. He's got his different accessories here that we're going to dive into. Let's pull it all out, pop it out. No twist ties, anything like that. I'm here for that. No twist ties needed. See you later. Goodbye. All right, let's put some of this stuff. Uh-oh, we got tape. Tape. We got tape everywhere. Pulling that over. Put it off to the side. There you go. All right, Epic Hacks. Highly Articulated Character Kit System, all in red. A nice stand. I'm here for this. Like I said, stands, great idea with any action figure. I love that. But we'll still do the ringside collectible stand test. Why wouldn't we? But we do get accessories here. No extra hands or anything like that. We do get two swords, knives. It's a little long to be a knife, so I guess we'll call it a sword. Nice bronze handles on both of these. Both different handles. A crazy sword here with a little different angle to it there. You don't see that a whole lot. I'm guessing that's for reaching around and gutting people, sticking it in there and pulling up. Ooh, it's deadly game being a gladiator, as we do know. More traditional sword right here. Both looking good. No issues with either of those. And then we do got this, and I'm not sure. I guess we'll see. We'll see how this works, but it is a big... It almost looks like it goes over the hand. It's almost like something a pirate would have. We'll talk about a pirate in a future video with these guys here. But a big old axe on the end, nice and bronze looking. I guess we'll stick it and see. Yeah, it does. I think it just goes over the hand. There you go. It's kind of a weapon that you add onto the hand there, like so. So you can do whatever you want with that. Choose your own adventure. Very interesting weapon. I'm here for it. Looking good. Then when you get a gladiator helmet, like a Roman helmet type thing, very interesting. You got the big fin on the top, big old hat, very nice patina. I think patina is the word to this. A little rust action. Definitely looks aged. Definitely looks old. Definitely an interesting mask on this. To me, I'm all about the skeletons of this, so I don't know if I would use this on his head because it blocks that beautiful skeleton face. So, but it is interesting. A nice helmet does feel like a gladiator, something a gladiator would have, so that makes a lot of sense to me. And then, of course, a gladiator always has to have a shield, and this does look really cool. I love the attention to detail with the wood, kind of the wood backing on this, and then you got the handles in the front looking old. You got the nice kind of rust color as well. A little bit of a, I don't know if that's a leaf pattern or what you would call that on there, but it does look really nice. It definitely feels like something an old school gladiator would have, so I'm here for that. But now we dive into the skeleton figure. Let's figure out our thoughts on this guy right here. Now, the first thing I can feel right off the bat when I pick him up, is we've probably all dealt with a skeleton figure somewhere. Somewhere in our travels, we've dealt with a skeleton a time or two, possibly. And a lot of the times, they feel very loose. And I guess a skeleton, you think of it, they're just a bag of bones. They're just chilling out. But this guy just feels tight. His joints feel good. There's good movement to the joints. Got a good weight to him. Not too heavy, not too light. Because like I said, a lot of skeletons are just really loose figures and the joints aren't tight at all. And they feel very light. Very like almost like paper thin light. But no, this one has a little bit of weight to it. A little bit of heft to it. And I'm here for that. I mean, it's not as heavy as a big Marvel Legend figure, but it does have a little weight to it, so I do like that here. Very good coloring to the bones. A little dark, of course. I guess bones, it's kind of what you think of. They could be black if they caught on fire. They could be pure white. They could be a grayish tone. And this kind of is about what you'd think a skeleton would be like. Maybe it's a little darker than what you think of with a skeleton, but it's a gladiator skeleton. It's got to be that way. Definitely does look good. Now, you do get the skirt going on, the Roman gladiator skirt. It isn't removable. He does got the big harness up here on the top. I do like there is storage for one of the weapons back there. I'm guessing this big sword, probably. Look at that. So you can store that on the back. Absolutely love that. I love to be able to have everything on my figures instead of having to have baggies of accessories and things. So that does work for me. He does got these big old shin guards here. I believe, correct me if I'm wrong once again, he was a member of the Oakland A's very briefly as Terry Steinbach's backup as a catcher. It was a wild time in the late 80s. The A's were on a roll, as we do know, winning the World Series in 89. Never forget. But they hired a skeleton. Yes, believe it or not. It's kind of like back in the 70s, you know, the A's were known for this kind of stuff. They grabbed a guy that was in the Olympics, one of the speed runners out there in the Olympics, and they used him to pitch run. So the A's always thinking, grabbed a skeleton, but Terry Steinbach was just too good. They had to do this. All hail the old Terry Steinbach. Shout out to Terry Steinbach, good friend of the channel. I'm sure he's watching. I'm sure he is. But looking really nice here. I like the lion on the knee there. Just really good shin protectors, leg protectors, whatever you want to call it. And then on the back, he's even got that going there, a little bit extra protection. And then he's got his bare skeleton feet. Of course, articulation going to be the same for both these. I guess we'll walk through it on this one really quick. Arms do go all the way around. No bicep cut, obviously. You do get the side to side on the elbows, single jointed elbows. Hands on a nice ball, so you get the back forth, all side to side, all the articulation you really need there. Head, of course, back forth, side to side, plenty of movement there. Will it have jaw articulation? I think if you make a... Oh, yeah. I was going to say, if you make a skeleton figure, you got to have jaw articulation. That is key to any skeleton figure. That's probably the most important articulation, in all honesty, on a skeleton figure. And he does have articulation here. I absolutely love that. The head looking really, really nice. Looking dark. Looking evil like a skeleton should. Big old eye sockets. Teeth showing. I'm here for that, of course. Does he got a hula hoop? Uh-oh. Moving around here. All right, we got the waist articulation. Plenty of waist articulation, honestly. I thought he might have an ab crunch in there. Doesn't Oh, you do got a little twist up there at the top. It's a little hard to get to, but you do got a little extra articulation up at the top. And then you get the waist, like I said, all over the place. He can do those big old skeleton splits. There's nothing stopping a skeleton from being the next Spider-Man, really, in all honesty. You can go forward there, knee articulation, then ankles back, forth, side to side. Plenty of articulation. Very poseable, very movable figures, very free-flowing figures, and very nice, tight joints on this guy as well. Now, I'm going to check just for science. Does he fit on a ringside collectible stand? I don't think it's going to work, though. I don't think it's going to work out. Nope, not going to work out. Too small. But, of course, he is going to fit on this stand. Boy, he better fit on this stand. Oh, my gosh, he's tight, though. He's tight, but, yes, he will fit. They got multiple peg holes on here, so you can kind of display them, move them around however you want to. But you got all kinds of different spots, and I love that it comes with a stand. So I am here for that. Not so bad right here. I can see a lot of people picking and choosing between this line. Maybe the Gladiator isn't necessarily for you, but there's got to be a skeleton that resonates with you somewhere along the line. And maybe it is this one. Maybe it's the old Barbarian. You can have this guy squaring off against Conan the Barbarian in your Conan collection. That's where I might put this one. We'll see what happens. But the Barbarian looking good there. Very similar packaging design, of course. It has the Barbarian instead of the Gladiator on this one. Epic hacks. Of course, the Barbarian, the old Deathmonger. Oh, yes, a good old Deathmonger there. On the back, got that same cross cell going on. Big blurbage here. I will stop the, or you guys can't stop the video if you want to read that whole thing there. Beautiful glamour shots as well. I'm here for it. Let's get the old Deathmonger out of the package. See what all the fuss is about. And let me tell you, there's fuss. There's always fuss about a skeleton. Of course there is. But looking good. See you later. Goodbye. Plastic prison. We get the stand once again. You get a big old sword. You get a big old axe. You got a big old... What is that called? A mace? Is that called a mace? I don't know. It reminds me of Hawkman, though. Shout out to my dad. Hawkman fan number one. My dad loves him some Hawkman, and Hawkman would always swing that thing around. At least back in the Super Friends era, he would. See you later. We saw this earlier. Get the tape off. Tape off to the side. We saw this Epic Hack stand earlier, so we don't need to go over that again. Gonna pop this out. Oh, we got some extra feet on this guy. That'll be interesting. See you later. Goodbye. Let's break it down. Choose your own feet adventure. He does come with boots on, which is interesting. If you don't like the boots look, give him his skeleton feet, so you can do that. Very interesting, but they just pop in, pop out like any hand or anything else we have. So we're used to this with other figure lines, of course, but definitely interesting. I do like the option there. If I want to use the boots, I got the boots. If I want skeleton feet, I got skeleton feet. I can choose my own feet adventure. I did talk about this big old mace. Absolutely love this. Just a brutal weapon from back in the day. Did they ever really use these, though? I'm sure they did somewhere, but definitely would suck to get hit by something like this. Nice coloring to it. Very spiky, very dangerous. Nice handle. I love the old brown wood there and then the silver spike on the end. You can stab somebody in the eye and then conk them on the head. Man, you're off to the Barbarian races if you do that. Big old sword here. Now, this is a sword. I talked about this one being feeling a little short. This is a sword. This is nice. Love the up and down angles there. The silver blade. Some dings and dents in the blade along the way. Of course, this is a sword that's seen some things and been inside some things, probably. Got the spike on the end. Nice handle as well. All day long, a very, very good sword. And then we turn our attention over to the old axe. Reminds me of He-Man's battle axe. Got the wood color down below, looking really nice. Nice decorative handle. Spike on the end once again. And a nice blue coloring to the silver here. I like that a whole lot. But once again, got some dings and dents to it. It's seen some things. It's seen some battle. Now we get down to the old Barbarian here. And like I said, you can put this with your Conan the Barbarian. You can put this a lot of different ways. Of course, it's the same skeleton. Got to get the most out of your molds. Same articulation. We're not going to walk through that. But the difference is the skin tone color. The bone color? How about the bone color? Where we got more of a greenish hue on this one, where we have more of a kind of a grayish color over there. A little bit more green on this one here, but definitely looks like a skeleton. No denying it is a skeleton. You got the jaw articulation. Now, he does have a helmet. Helmet is removable. At first, I did not think it was removable, but it is. Nice horns on the top. Looks like something a Barbarian or maybe a Viking or something would have. So you can choose your own adventure. I do like it. This almost looks like something out of Golden Axe. Kind of reminds me of Golden Axe skeleton as well. Got the nice vest in the front. You got a spot for the sword in the back. Once again, storing all the weapons on the figure. I'm here for that. Big ol' Eternia's famous loincloth down here for the Barbarian, looking good. And then the boots. The boots look a little bit strange, but it is kind of cool. It's kind of fun to think that this guy, like, decayed and died and was resurrected. And he died with his boots on, one may say, like a young Iron Maiden. But I definitely like the looks of this guy here as well. Definitely looking good. I think I do prefer the Barbarian to the Gladiator, though. I resonate more with a Barbarian than a Gladiator. What can I say? But he definitely does look good. He definitely feels good in hand. I do like this one a whole lot. Does he fit on the Epic Hacks stand? Yes, he does. What do you know? It's like he was made for this stand, you could almost say. But there he is, looking very, very nice here. You got gripping hands on these skeletons. No fists yet. We'll see if the other two have a fist. But I kind of like weapon-holding hands for my skeletons. I don't see a lot of skeletons going mano a mano out there. It just really doesn't happen a whole lot. But definitely interesting putting these guys together. Of course, same body, same mold. It's going to be that. But different things. We got a Gladiator and a Barbarian. But if we compare them to some other skeletons, how about Skeletor? Oh, yes. You could have these guys as kind of minions of Skeletor if you really wanted to. Always a possibility there. I did talk about Storm Collectibles, a little Golden Axe action. You could have these guys mix in with your Golden Axe figures very easily if you needed to. I love that height, size difference, or whatever you want to call it right there. Looking really, really good. Always love the Storm Collectibles figures. You could have Flint going toe-to-toe. There was that one G.I. Joe cartoon episode with those skeletons that one time. You could have these guys squaring off with some Joes if you really needed to. So that does work very good scale-wise. And I do got a little Marvel Legends action. You ever seen this Thor? How about a little Thor action here? So you have Thor squaring off against these guys. Obviously, Thor a little bit bigger of a Marvel Legend, but still looks really good. So really mix these in with your G.I. Joe. Mix them with your He-Man, your Golden Axe, your whatever you want to. Marvel Legends, you name it. They can be a versatile part of your collection if you need to. And I like what I see here. I'm here for skeletons. I think a lot of us like skeletons, enjoy skeleton figures, and that's what we got right here. So not a bad day at the office here. I do like these. I'm anxious to see where this line goes. Like I said, I did pre-order the wrestling one that's coming a year from now. Let's call it what is time. But we do got two more to unbox here on the channel. So after you watch this one, stay tuned for the other one. And the best way to stay tuned is, of course, to subscribe to this very YouTube channel and like this video and hit the notification bell and leave me a comment down below which skeleton you prefer between these two. And are you all in on skeletons? You picking any of these up? You picking and choosing? You passing? Let me know in the comments down below. Of course, don't forget to like this video either, like I always do say. But of course, the Patreon as well. You can get early access to videos like this. Bonus content, exclusive content, giveaways, Q&As, you name it. A whole heck of a lot going on the Patreon channel every single day. And it is truly your best way to support the channel. You can also support the channel over at ProWrestlingTees.com. Search Kyle Peterson. And don't forget about social media. SirPaul64 on Twitter. Instagram, the_Kyle_Peterson. So for the Gladiator and the Barbarian and skeletons everywhere, I am Kyle. See you guys all real soon.